That clear in your heart and your mind, if you're working for your salvation, you're missing the boat. It's by grace. But the way I receive grace is by faith, and faith requires an action, which we call, the King James call works. Okay? All right, so verse 17, even so, faith, I'm in 2:17, James 2:17. Even so, faith, if it hath not worked, is dead, being alone. Okay? So, faith without works is dead, lifeless. Because it's alone. Verse 18, yea, a man may say, thou hast faith, and I have works. Show me your faith without your works, and I will show you my faith by my works. Do you understand that? Everybody got that? In other words, a man might question you and say, you have faith, Bill has faith, James has works. But then he says, okay, show me your faith without any works. How do I see it? How do I know you got faith? And I'll show you my faith by my life. By what I'm doing. Okay? You see that? It's the corresponding action of how I believe changed my life. Hello? Everyone else in this room, I dare say. I think we're all saved people in here. Every one of us lives different because of our faith, of His grace, than we did before we met Him. Right? So we have works. Not works that saved us, but works because we are saved.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay? Are you all right with that? Anything to add to that? What?
Titus chapter 3.
Titus chapter 3.
Verses 4 through 8.
Praise the Lord. Yeah. Okay, everybody okay there? Got a question on that?
What about, it says, work out your salvation with fear and trembling.
Work out your salvation? Okay, good question, Bonnie. How would I work out my salvation? Anybody got any answer to that?
Right.
How about, that's a good question. John 6, and I believe verse 29, when they asked Jesus, how do I work the works of God? How do I work the works of God? How do I do it? By believing in the one whom He sent. Now let me just mention to you that if you think this Christian life is easy, you ain't living it.
Right.
Show me your faith without works, and I'll show you my faith by works.
Yeah.
Because what happens is, whenever you have every obstacle against you, the Word of God, and for instance, your rent needs to be paid, and it's screaming at you every second of every day, what are you going to do? The money's not there. I mean, it hounds you. It's relentless. Right? You ever been there? I pray you're not there, but if you've ever been there, you know what I'm talking about. Okay? So, with that coming at you like that, faith is not easy to sustain. Because your confession wants to be, by the way, Terry, you know we're having a little problem? You know, I know you're a prayer warrior, so that's why I wanted to share this with you. But you pray for me. How much you get paid this week? Got any extra there, Terry? Well, you see, if you just shut up and confess the word and stand strong. Now I'm telling you, you've got to be strong in this to do this. It's not easy. And you confess, bless God, I have it. Somebody say to you, well, how's the rent coming? You got your rent for this month? And you know you ain't got a penny of it. What do you say? I'm believing. Oh, that's hope.
That's her. That's what she says.
You got to say, yes.
Yes.
Jehovah Jireh.
Yes.
Mine. Because that's what you believe, see? It should just roll out. But it doesn't just roll out because you don't believe that most times. Most times you believe what the checkbook is saying. Every one of us do. And you see, that's the corresponding action, the works he's talking about, the good works. That faith is dead without them. And that's how come we don't receive from God. It's because we go by what we're seeing or feeling or tasting or touching instead of going by the Word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now that's the same way whenever we're feeling bad. We got sickness in our body. And so, you know, that sickness is continually reminding, she's fine. That sickness is continually reminding us. It's constantly hounding on you. You're hurting. You don't feel good. You're in bad shape. You may be dying. It keeps on. And then somebody, you feel awful, and then you see Bill, and he says, how you feeling today? What do you say? Well, Bill, I just got to tell you, it's been tough. I've had a real battle on my hand all this week. I couldn't make it to work a couple of days, and I'm feeling rough, but I believe God. No, you don't. No, you don't. You deceive yourself. You think you believe God. You see what I'm saying? This is the works. This is the corresponding action. This is not what you understand. I can't earn the healing that's available. I can't look good enough, smell good enough, be good enough, buy it, or do anything like that. It's available to me, but I've got to receive it by faith, and faith requires that I believe it enough to act upon it.
Amen.
That's the good word.
Amen.
You okay with that?
I just want to add to that also we play a victim now. We act like a victim. We're a victim of what's going on.
Maybe feeling sorry for ourselves, you mean?
Yeah, feeling sorry for ourselves, and then we surround ourselves by people that feel sorry for us.
Oh, that's good. That's right. You like company. Misery loves company.
That's right.
That's right. Got somebody else right here? Duke?
Praise the Lord.
Come on, Duke. Come on, somebody, Duke.
All right, let me see here.
That's enough, Duke. It's time to roll.
It's by works and faith that we are saved, right?
No. That's why we're going over this, though. That's good. Good question.
All right. So it's by works and believing. Where?
No. There's key words here. Through. Okay. Through is a big word here.
Yeah.
Meaning that's the vehicle to receive.
Okay.
All right. You're saved by His grace.
Okay.
By grace, you're saved.
Okay.
Through your belief,
okay.
Your acceptance.
Okay.
All right. Same way with healing.
All right.
Same way with financial provision. Same way with everything you get from God.
Okay.
It's all His grace that did it.
Okay.
And now I tap into it by my belief.
Okay.
Okay. You all right with that? Everybody okay with that?
Yeah.
Anybody got a problem with that?
No.
If you do, keep silent. No. Just kidding. Come on, somebody. Okay. She raised her hand first, and I'll be right back to you. Ladies first, right.
Why people say they're not worthy of this treatment?
Because the enemy has deceived them.
That's right.
You see, grace has made them worthy, but the enemy has said to them, you're just not good enough. You know, look what you did. It's called condemnation, too. Exactly right. And that's a good point because a lot of people miss it because they don't think they're good enough for it. But it has, that goes back to that works mentality of thinking you got to earn it. Was that your question?
No.
Oh. I thought maybe she stole your question.
No. It was great what you said because this is something I always say when we talk about our faith and our belief and works and so on. Sometimes we do fall short. Only God is perfect. Like I said in the sticker I read earlier, I was wanting to get, only God and Jesus is perfect. We aren't. People know we're Christian, we still commit wrongs. I may cut someone off in traffic, or I may drink.
Don't do that.
I may drink too much. I didn't mention it last Thursday, but a couple times lately I drank too much because I was stressed out. But then the devil wants to take hold of that, and people around you that aren't Christian, and say, oh, I thought you're Christian, or your own mind with the devil will play this all the time. They'll say, see, you're not Christian.
Right.
You're not believing in God. You're not faithful. You're not deserving. But this goes on even as a Christian.
Yeah.
We battled, and as you said earlier, if we're living a great life in this world, we aren't living the kind of Christian life we need to be. But don't ever let the devil get hold of anyone
right.
you do or people around you
right.
and discourage you and
right.
say, see, you're not worthy. And also, a lot of people will then rationalize that and say, well, if I didn't drink, I am worthless or I am this.
Right, and then it's fall into it worse.
And then it's just
exactly.
fall right in.
Exactly. Praise the Lord. Well, we're going to have to bring this to a close. Much fun as we're having. Praise the Lord. Well, it's a little unorthodox service today, but that's all right. Everybody's awake out there. I didn't hear no snoring today anymore. Praise the Lord. So, let me just close by saying that we may do this again next week because I want to be sure, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that everybody in here has hold of this grace. What is grace and what are the works? What are these two things? It's very important because what happens is if there's any confusion, it filters not only on your salvation, but it filters into your divine health, your prosperity, all that we receive from God. And if we don't get out these misunderstandings now, then they'll carry over and block out all our other blessings. And God wants you blessed. Hallelujah. He wants you prosperous. He delights in your prosperity. He wants you healed because he took 39 stripes down to the bone for you. So he must be pretty serious about you walking in divine health. Hallelujah. So he wants you to have these things, but you must receive them through faith. Grace is paid for them, but faith is the receptacle. You got something else, Bunny?
Yes, I want to say we are one body.
Yes.
Right.
And if there's one member out,
yes.
it don't work right.
That's
right.
We got to keep the wheel going good.
That's right.
Yes. We're going to sway.
That's right.
So as one body, let's get into faith.
That's right.
And walk it.
Preach it.
And walk it. And believe it.
That's right. Flo, did you have something? I thought you raised your hand. Oh, I see. You're giving James orders up here, huh? Praise the Lord.
As usual.
Praise the Lord. Now we don't pray again. Praise God. Now, I pray you learned something today. If there's confusion still there, please don't just sit there and wallow in it and let it get worse. Please, me or James, or Flo, or somebody that can help you with that, because it is that'll rob you of your faith. So we want to clear that up, you know. And although this is basic, the thing about this is that this very basic is the root of why you don't believe in the major thing. So you got to start here, clear this up, and then you'll see the rest of it will clear.